Yeah. It's Fallout 4, ladies and gentlemen. I'm excited about this one. I've been a Fallout fan since the first one back in like 98 or 99, something like that. At least that's when I first played it. And I fell in love with it, especially Fallout 2. Fallout 2 is my favorite ever. And they always start out this way. It's amazing. I'm going to shut up and let you watch this. And then we'll get back to it when they give me control.
In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes.
That's right, guys. War never changes. So it said it was 2077. Now, I've played up to leaving the vault just to get, like, settings and whatnot the way I needed them. So I know that some shit happens. But 2077 is... we're just going to go ahead and stick with this guy. 2077 is before the first game. The first game took place in 2161. The second one took place, I believe, 200 years after that. And I don't remember the timeline for 3 in New Vegas. But right now we're before the bombs drop and the war starts and everything. So I think it's pretty cool. We got Codsworth here.
Thanks, Codsworth.
I like Codsworth. Thanks, Codsworth. All right, let's go check out the rooms here. We've got the bathroom. This thing, you can, another fine, you know, product, get little snippets.
Atomics International.
That's right. Let's go in here. Check out little baby Shaun. Baby Sean's our little guy. It's all wrapped up and snug. Get in there, Codsworth. Do your thing, buddy. I'm going to go hang out with my wife a little bit. Hey, baby.
We should take Codsworth to be serviced soon, don't you think?
Yeah, sure.
Now, who left those here?
But I really like, I've always liked Fallout's style. Nope, let's turn that off. I've always liked Fallout's style. It's like the future according to like the 50s or whatever.
Nuka-Cola.
And I think that's pretty cool. It's got a really cool style, especially when everything goes to shit. Hello, sir. I got it. What's up, buddy?
Vault-Tec calling.
Vault-Tec? Remind me again?
Why, we're about you, sir, and helping secure your future. You see, Vault-Tec is the foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters. Vaults, if you will. Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
I'm here now.
So you are.
Yeah.
So you are. Now, I know you're a busy fellow. So
I am a very busy fellow.
Time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family's service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Sounds great.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of...
total atomic annihilation.
I just need to verify some information. That's all.
Tell me more about this vault.
Oh, it has all the amenities of the modern home, I assure you. Not to mention total protection from nuclear radiation and hostile mutants. A better future underground. It's not only our mission, it's our passion.
Now, I can't wait for the world to end.
That's the spirit. Now, let's see.
Alright, so we're just gonna see how much you can carry, damage melee attacks. Perception is super important. Endurance, also important. Let's go with charisma as also important. Intelligence. Yeah, let's go with it that way. I mean, I know strength is a little low, so I'm going to have problems with carry weight. But I've always been an agility player, and I know intelligence and charisma help you with dialogue options and stuff. So let's go ahead and go that way. Then we're going to name this guy Arcee, obviously. Because I am Arcee. And we're done.
Wonderful. That's everything. Just going to walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Yep. See you later, buddy.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind.
Hey, lady.
That's worth a little paperwork, right?
Whoa, he did like a little pirouette before he went.
Good answer.
I have my moments. Hun?
Nervous? Don't be. Everyone's going to love the speech.
Alright, let's go check on baby Shaun, my little buddy, my little bro.
You heard Codsworth. Go on.
I'm going. Come on, little baby Shaun, you need to chill out.
How are the two most important men in my life?
He loves me.
Spin the mobile a bit. He loves that.
Let's see if I can go in here. I've never actually tried that. Blast radius.
Much better now, huh? Listen, after breakfast.
Whoa, that was
I was thinking
weird.
We could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Yeah, sounds like fun.
So I've noticed with the cutscenes, if you try to move or if you move your camera too much, it kicks you out of the cutscene, but it doesn't stop the cutscene. So you can still. I mean, it's not really cutscenes. I'm, I guess, more, more, like cuts to conversation type
yes.
of thing. Yeah, so the war is happening now, ladies and gentlemen. For the first time, we get to see what happens to the normal guys at the beginning of the war. Because, remember in Fallout 3 with some DLC, you got to play the actual invasion as a soldier. Absolutely devastated.
We need to get to the vault. Now!
Yeah, we gotta get out of here, lady. All these people. Run. Come on, lady. You got this. I could sprint, but it always, like, you sprint way faster than her. So, that's not what I'm just going to go ahead and run along with her. Man, this game is beautiful, though. Look at it. Look at it. It is beautiful. It's a lot more colorful than usual than a Fallout game. And I know it's before everything happens, but it's very colorful. Prepare for the future. That looks like the mobile game cover. Vault Dweller or whatever it was called. Hey, buddy.
We're on the list.
Infant, adult male, adult female.
He's not even looking at the list.
Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
Let's go.
What's gonna happen to all those?
These guys in the power armor, man. I love that power armor. It's like iconic. It's almost as iconic as Vault Boy for Fallout. The Brotherhood of Steel, man. That's where it's at.
Sir, we need to send you down to the vault.
Yeah, I'm going. Also, this is the first time I've ever seen a vault that opens this way. Usually it's an upright door
almost
into
there.
A mountain.
We're gonna be okay.
But this is just an elevator.
I love you. Both of you.
We love you too.
Never seen that before, so I thought that was pretty cool. There we go. Better get this thing going.
Hold on.
You better get this thing going, because it's coming.
Oh God.
That's awesome.
We did it.
We did. So did all these people. What we got? Ms. Whitfield, Mr. Whitfield, Ms. Abel, Mr. Abel. Mr. Russell does not have anybody with him.
Up the stairs in an orderly fashion. No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated.
Don't worry, bro. You'll find somebody.
Vault 111.
Maybe in Vault 111.
Underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
This is our new home.
Sure is. Let's get out of here.
Later.
No. Don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now.
Are we, though? Because I've played Fallout before, sir. There will be rad roaches and death claws galore pretty soon. Go, man, go. Quit walking all weird. What the hell is that guy doing? What the hell are you looking at me, lady? You're talking to him. Give him a suit. I'm next. Don't worry. Go, dude, go. I want my suit. I want to get on with it.
Thanks.
Thank you. See, it was really quick for me.
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where
what?
To go.
Oh.
All right.
Hello. You don't need a suit? All right, let's go.
See? This is our new
Are you coming, Nora? Come on. Oh, he's right there. I thought it was that guy.
Not that the others aren't great, mind you.
Our home. Everything we had.
It looks all super advanced, doesn't it?
Sir.
Oh God, honey. What if we didn't make it? I know this is a difficult
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation.
Just checking every medical items we have to get them in.
You got these crazy looking pods. They look like cryogenic chambers.
Excuse me. Step into the chamber whenever you're ready.
All right, man. Decontamination pod. Looks awfully frosty in there. Instantly put my iconic vault suit on. She's already got hers on. She changed right in front of all these people. I don't know how I feel about that.
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal.
Come on. Let's go.
Procedure complete.
I want to get in the vault. Start my new life.
In 5, 4.
Clearly not an actual decontamination chamber. They're cryogenically freezing us. A little bait and switch going on. Why they would do that. Yeah, and it's all dark out there. Everybody's gone.
This is the one. Here.
That guy's wearing the classic Raider outfit. I don't know what's going on with her. Let me out. They're trying to take baby Shaun. Little baby Shaun's my bro. Oh shit, dude. Jeez. Fucking. Yeah, I'm gonna get you, buddy. I'll remember that scar, too. Don't you worry. They set me up to freeze again. Let me out. Sons of bitches. Come on.
Come on. There has to be a release.
Oh, there totally is, buddy. It's right there.
Oh, God.
Check on Nora. She is totally dead. But I got a wedding ring. I don't know if that's going to be significant at all, but I have it. All these guys are dead. And if we run over here, we can check this terminal. And we're going to go to pod occupant status. Right here. Nope. Okay. Yeah, so nobody's in that pod. Not sure why. But we've got this one. Unknown. Let's look at one of these that are dead. Give us a better idea what's going on here. So, deceased cause of death, asphyxiation due to life support failure. Now that's the same for everyone except Nora and Shaun and Arcee here. Now what I don't understand, and I guess I just haven't gotten far enough to figure out, because like I said, I only played up to the end of this little part. Why didn't our life support fail? Did the raider and the lady kill everyone? If we go in here, there's even more people. Everybody's dead. There's a terminal on the other side, but it says the same shit. Let's go ahead and pick that guy up. It's got the same stats as the one I'm wearing, so I don't really know why I picked it up, but go on down here. Some rad roaches. What was that? What? Oh, it's just the desk. Grab that stim pack. Check this security terminal out. Look at these security logs. So, God, finally happened. The world's over. Barely got all the residents inside. Not everyone made it. Now it's just us and the icebergs. I don't get it. Eggheads tried to explain to me that keeping them frozen is a big experiment for a better future or something. I don't know. It just doesn't seem right. We're smiling at them all the time before putting them on ice. Shouldn't we have told them or something? So, I'm going to go on record and say that because Fallout 3 and New Vegas went into it a lot more in-depth than 1 and 2, every single vault from Vault Tech was actually like an experiment. They told people they were just down there to keep them safe, but they were actually running experiments on them. There was crazy ones like a weird sound all the time that drove people insane and stuff like that. So this vault was no better. Christmas Underground... None of the scientists came. Whatever. Just a few more months till the all clear. The all clear is like, I guess, I think it says something like 180 days. A few weeks left. People getting stir crazy. They think the all clear is never coming. I've already read these, and it's just like flavor. I mean, if you want to read them, when I'm skimming over them, just pause it. The main door is malfunctioning. The only way out is the overseer's evacuation tunnel. And looks like there's going to be some meeting where they're going to talk about what the hell's going on and what they can do. And then they decide that no all clear is coming. And that he almost murdered Stanley for dropping a salt cracker because they're running out of food. So they all kind of want a mutiny and whatnot. What we got over here? Oh, that's where I went. Okay. Put your damn fist down, dude. Or block. Hello, sir. Would you like to fight? Ah. Go into the mess hall here.
Roaches.
Beer bottles. Now we're going to check this out because there's something cool on this computer. Now this is just, you know, like a whatever. But we're going to do, it's just talking about this game. So we're going to go ahead and start this game. Yeah, start. How do I start, damn it? I'm pushing all the... Well, I didn't mean to push that button. No, I don't want to quit the game. Oh. Spacebar. Alright. Should have known that. So it's basically just, you know... It's like Donkey Kong. But cool. Let's see if we can get over there. Oh, okay. For some reason, my jump's not working. I had to figure that out. There we go. Don't follow me. Oh, come on! Alright, well, we'll get back to this later. Because... We can actually take this and use it in a... Oh, damn it. Use it in a different terminal later, which is the whole reason I wanted to come in here. But let's check out some other stuff. I'm going to take that toaster. I'm going to take that hot plate. I guess, going to drink from that. But the reason I took those is because there's kind of like a crafting system. And I'm not exactly sure if I understand what counts as like crafting materials. So I'm just going to start taking all kinds of metal stuff just to make sure. But let's move on and kill ourselves some more roaches. Just not that roach because he is dumb and just kind of sits there. There we go. All right, moving on. Hey, buddy. Suck it. Suck it. Look at this guy.
What happened here? Where is everyone?
Yeah, so I haven't really actually figured out how far or how long he was in that cryogenic chamber. But remember, we started at 2077. First game took place in 2061 or 2161. So there's no telling. Maybe I should take the red roach meat. There's no telling actually what year this game takes place on the timeline. But I will take that, and all those. Is the Overseer here? I'm going to check out the Overseer's terminal. We're not going to look at any of that crap, but we're going to look at his logs. His final staff orientation is complete. All but a few of the residents down in Sanctuary Hills have been enrolled, several from Concord as well, Vault-Tec supervisors. Came up this week to do a technical review with me. The vault is ready and open. I can only imagine what wonders our residents will get to witness. The notion of leaping forward in time, I almost wish I could join them and see the promise of our future realized. No, sir, you do not. We're lucky that most of the staff's nearby when the early warning came through. We had less notice than expected, but only Nordhagen was missing when we sealed the entrance. I wonder if we're going to run into like a ghoul version of Nordhagen later or something. Resident admittance went smoothly. Everyone made it, even the family that waited until the last minute, which I would assume was us. Too overwhelmed to question the cryogenic pods. So see, the staff knew what was going on. Those sons of bitches. Issue of pod C3. Now, C3 had one of the people that was in my block. Nothing life-threatening. We realized almost too late the pod was malfunctioning. The cryogenic array almost started thawing her out. We're not sure, but I suspect a hiccup in Vault-Tec's remote override systems may have sent an errant signal. I'm kind of wondering if that was on purpose. Like, maybe they didn't even tell the people that worked here what they were going to do. Because something always, you know, they're testing things. And seeing how people react to certain things in these vaults. It's all one big, like, experiment. There's been no all-clear signal yet, even though we're nearing the end of the 180-day mandatory shelter period. Supplies were never intended to last much more than that. If people think we can just leave when the 180 days are up, they're insane. The radioactive exposure will still be potent enough to fry everyone if the vault seals are breached. that early. Whole point of the all clear was to receive additional instructions from the main office. I don't know what to do. I can't open the vault. I can't expect our supplies to last forever. I just, and then, like, there's no more pages, so I don't know what he could just. And then we've got mutiny. Security personnel mutinied. They want to leave. He doesn't want to leave because he doesn't want to get irradiated. And he's putting everything on lockdown. And if anybody rises up, he said, that's okay. That's fewer mouths to feed. But the main reason we're doing this is to open this tunnel. So let's get out of here. But first, we're going to look around a little bit. There we go. Another gun because of the repair system. I don't know if that was bullets or cigarettes. I wasn't paying attention. The repair system, if it's anything like the older games, you use weapons to repair other weapons. Like, you take parts. I'm gonna take that preserved cigarette pack. You never know who's going to want one of those. And we got nothing. All right. Oh, here we go. I'll take that. Let's get this bad boy ready. Hello, sir. Yeah, suck it. Who else wants some? Oh. Okay. Fuck over here. Alright. Alright, we're good. We're good. If there's any more, we're gonna vat some. There we go. Pow! Oh no, he ran like a little wuss. Okay, that's enough, bro. Stop. You're wasting bullets when you... Oh, hello. All right. We'll work on our gunplay a little bit later. All right, so we're trying to get out of this vault because we need to figure out who took baby Shaun and killed my wife. So I'm not having that kind of stuff. Is there a roach somewhere? Oh. The hip fire, understandably, as in most games, not that great.
Did anyone get out?
But this bad boy is what we're looking for. The Pip Boy. Super important to every Fallout game. Now, this is the inventory system, the stat system, healing, all that stuff. All happens on the Pip-Boy. So I'm wondering if I can put the holotape in this, because it said no holotape found. But I don't know how to do that. But anyway, we got our status, our special, which is our stats, and our perks, which we have nothing. Your inventory, all this good stuff. This is my current quest. And then map, which as you can see is relatively big. I don't know how far that actually is, you know, in units of measurements and whatnot. And then we got the radio, which I don't necessarily know how to tune it. But it's cool that you can look around. I don't know why you would need to do that. Because you can't do anything. You have to hold the button. But that's it for the Pip-Boy. Got what we need. Let's get out of here. It's going to open the door. It's going to open the door. And then we got to take that the elevator back up and see what the world has come to. So this kind of door right here is generally what vaults are in all the other games. That's how you get in. But this one's got that added elevator, which I think is pretty cool and different, I guess, considering the rest of the Fallout games. There may have been one that I just don't remember that was an elevator down into it, but I really don't think so. I think I did that a little bit prematurely. Alright, let's get down there to that elevator. Let's go, buddy. Open it up. I'm in a hurry. Let's go. Nope, we're good. Let's get out of here. Why, thank you. Now, in Fallout 3, when you first leave the vault, it was one of the coolest experiences I've ever seen in a video game because I love post-apocalyptic games, and this one does not disappoint. Look at this place, man. It's like nothing. It looks nothing like it did before we went in. This place was absolutely destroyed. And that is our town. So let's get down there and check it out. But first, we're going to check out what's going on in here. Got some bottles. I don't know. I'm going to take one of them just in case, but that fuse, I think, is going to be important. We got some Stimpak, Radex, purified water is important because most water is radiated. And I think that button just brings that up if it's down. I don't know how it would be down. But, yeah. Let's get down there and check it out, man. Sorry, I didn't mean to do that. Sorry. Now, stepping in the water doesn't give me any radiation. Let's go in here. Take that desk fan for some metal. I'm going to take that. And look at that. We now are one cap richer. Caps being the currency in the wasteland. It's the Nuka-Cola caps. We've got some cram, which is drugs. Maybe we can sell that. I'm not going to be using any. This is about as far as I got before I stopped so that I could get ready to record. So now, everything that I find is going to be new. I don't know what that is. Silt bean. And you are experiencing it with me, ladies and gentlemen. And I, of course, do appreciate that. I'm glad that you chose my video to watch. I'm going to try to make it entertaining. Also, I'm going to be doing, I think, around 30 to 45 minute episodes. Just depends on what I can get into. Maybe they'll be heavily edited because this is going to be a long game. There's going to be a lot of traveling and looking around at things. So I'll try and make sure that everything that I show you is awesome and fun. Let's see. Oh, hello. How are you, sir? Yeah? Is that it? No, that is not it. Hello. Get the hell out of here. Although he did hit me. And give me some radiation. I don't need a cigar, I think. Let's take a look at this place, man. Oil can. I know that is probably something. I'm picking up metal things. I don't know if that's the way to do it. I don't really know anything about the crafting. If I only had a bobby pin. I need a bobby pin. The classic lockpick. See what's in here. Nuka cherry. Yum yum deviled eggs. That's what I'm talking about. I don't need any more rad roach. Rad roach meat, I don't think. Whoa. I'll take that ball peen hammer, sure. Why not? And a screwdriver. It's like Christmas. Oh. Hello? Oh, it's Codsworth.
It's really you.
It sure is, buddy. Good to see you. Who knows, man? Oh, wait, we do know.
She's in a better place.
Sir, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to
I could use a distraction, Codsworth.
It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades.
I don't think either of those are gonna... take my mind off them killing my wife.
He's gone. God damn it. Someone took him. Someone stole my son.
It's worse than I thought. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years.
200 years, so... What, 2277 then, maybe?
200 years? What? Are you...
A bit over 210, actually.
2287. I am actually hungry. Withhold information or caps, you can attempt to persuade them into sharing both.
Codsworth, you're acting a little bit weird. What's wrong?
Yellow, orange, and red.
Oh, sir, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed. Nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing. And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car. The car. How do you polish rust?
Well, if you were a good robot, you wouldn't let it get to that rust situation going on there.
What do you know, Kyle?
Such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were dead. I did find this holotape. I believe the missus was going to present it to you as a surprise. But then, well, everything happened.
A holotape? What's on it?
I believe it's a private message for you. My etiquette protocols would not permit me to play it for myself. Any standard holotape reader...
Better be some boobs.
Play it back. Oh, like that Pip-Boy on your arm. That should work brilliantly. Now, enough feeling sorry for myself. Shall we search the neighborhood together? The missus and young Shaun may turn up yet.
Have you seen anything dangerous?
Oh, just the usual, sir. Pesky neighborhood dogs. And mosquitoes.
Have you seen anything dangerous?
Oh, just to you, huh. Sir.
Right.
All right. Well, sure.
Right. Lead the way.
Proud to serve, sir.
Cool. Give me 1 second, everybody. All right. We're back. Let's follow Codsworth around. See what he's got up his sleeve. Where you going, buddy? You're just running into stuff, huh? Okay.
Hey, Codsworth.
Sir,
are you really stuck on that?
Search protocols are on full alert.
Yeah, it looks like it. You look drunk. Damn, dude, chill. Oh, sorry, Codsworth. Sorry. Yeah, you done? What have we in here? Oh, some Nuka-Cola, some pork and beans. I'm into it. I'll take that toaster.
My senses are picking up.
Some bubble gum.
Follow me.
All right, I guess we'll come back because I think that I'm supposed to be, you know, actually following him. So we'll come back and explore this area in a little bit. Are you? Where? Inside. Yeah, take him out. Cool. Take a bloat flag land or a boat flag land.
Your family isn't here either. They're really gone, aren't they?
Yeah, that's what I said.
Sean's out there, Codsworth. I need to find him.
What about Concord, sir?
Concord? It's not Concord.
Me with sticks a few times before I had to run back home.
Thanks for your help, Cosworth.
Good luck, sir.
Oh, I should have asked him about Concord.
I know you will. I shall remain here and secure the home.
Yeah? All right, let's take a look in this area a little bit. I mean, we're right here. Might as well. I don't want either of those. I don't want a plastic pumpkin. So I don't have any, oh, I'll take that, though. I don't have any Halloween candy to throw in it, you know? Is this... Can I get back there? Oh, there's nothing to grab anyway. That's weird. It looks like a little fortress that somebody made. Oh, hello, sir. Oh, I'll take that. A pipe pistol. Let's check that bad boy out. Uses a different ammo, and it's not as strong, but it fires a little faster. Huh. Oh, damn it. Alright, well, we'll keep that in case we run out of 10mm ammo. But, yeah. You know what? I'm going to take that, because I love America. In any case, guys, I believe that's about all the time I've got for this first episode. I hope you're liking this game. I mean, I know I haven't gotten into anything crazy, but it's Fallout. And if you're here, you probably know about Fallout, and you probably like Fallout. And if you're just checking the game out to see if you want to get it, I think it's pretty cool so far. But, you know, I haven't really gotten into anything, but it feels like a Fallout game. It's pretty awesome. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, guys. If you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. If you want to see more videos of Fallout 4 or any of the other videos that I've done, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. If you have anything to say, go ahead and throw it down in the comments. Remember, my name is Russ's Corpse. Thanks for watching again, and I'll see you guys in the next video.